Hi friends, today we are going to start with understanding of how to draw a 8-point DIT FFT flow graph. So we are going to see how a 8-point DIT FFT flow graph looks like. In a DIT FFT flow graph, we know that the time sequence are divided. So for an 8-point FFT, we have an input sequence with 8 total subsamples. So let us say x of 0, x of 1, x of 2, x of 3, x of 4, x of 5, x of 6 and x of 7. So we have this total series of samples that are 8 samples, 0 to 7, and we are going to divide them first in the range of 4 and 4, that is n by 2, and further 4 point can be divided into 2 points. So the first dissection or first division will be moving out or removing all even samples together and removing all odd samples together. So let us say x even of n is composed of x of 0, then x of 2, then x of 4 and x of 6, and x of odd sample will look like x of 1, x of 3, x of 5 and x of 7. Okay, so we have divided the n is equal to 8 into n is equal to 4 and n is equal to 4 equal parts. Okay, now we will further divide this 4-point FFT to 2-point FFT. So I will further place these two samples together and these two samples together. Again, we will place these two samples together and these two samples together. Okay, so I will make this is 4-point, this is 8-point, and finally I will be getting a 2-point, below which division is not possible. So a 2-point FFT, let's say x 1 of n will be nothing but will be taking group of x of 0 and x of 4, and x 2 of n will be further grouped as x of 2 and x of 6. Okay, whereas x 3 of n, which is a group of x 0, is x of 1 and x of 5, and x 4 of n is equal to x of 3 and x of 7. So we have this 4 subsets of the complete 8-point FFT. So how will we be grouping first as even set and odd set. In even set and odd set, we will further have one even set and one odd set, one even set and one odd set. Likewise, there will be groups of input samples. So now let us go for the flow graph. There will be in all 8 lines. So let us draw 8 total horizontal lines. 1, 2, 3, 4. So we will group 4, 4 together. 1, 2, 3 and 4. Okay. So for first 4, I will write as x of 0, then x of 4, then x of 2 and then x of 6. Right. So this is one group, this is second group. In odd set, we have x1 with x5 and x3 with x7. That is in the odd. Further subgroups are this one. Okay, now the first point, after putting the samples, just put two crosses on each links. Likewise, so I'll make two cross marks in each links. Right, wherever the two line meets, it's a addition. So wherever these two lines meet, x0 comes from here, x4 comes from here, so this is x0 plus x of 4. Now here there is a multiplier minus 1, here there is a multiplier minus 1, here there is a multiplier minus 1, and here also there is a multiplier minus 1. So whenever from here x0 will come and here x4 will come, but here x4 is multiplied by minus 1, so I will have x0 minus x4. Okay, then we will have x2 plus xx, and here we will have x2 minus xx, here we will have x1 plus x5, and then we will have x1 minus x5, here we will have x3 plus x7, and here we will have x3 minus x7. Correct? That is a first stage. So let us call this as first stage. Let us go to second stage. Now in the second stage, you have to connect the first line to the third line. So the first line I will connect to the third line. Again, second line to the fifth line, and so on. Okay, but don't carry this down. Now this will go up. Okay, so in second stage I will skip one line in between and connect the crisscrosses. Here also same way, first line, third line, second line, fourth line, here first line to third line, and second line to fourth line. Okay, then we will put minus 1 on the last two lines. Here also minus 1 and here also minus 1. Now there is a multiplier before this section over here, which I write as W 8 raised to 0 and W 8 raised to 2. Here also two second lines, W 8 raised to 0 and W 8 raised to 2. Okay, so now I have a multiplier. I will multiply first the sample which is coming from here, and then we are going to add further. Okay, so what it will do now, it will adjust. Like, now let us count this big sample x0 plus x1 as, let us give the name as x1, this as x2, this as x3, this as x4, this as x5, this as x6, this is x7, and let this be x8. Okay, so now when I'll bring this, I'm going to get x1 here, I'm going to get x2 here, I'm going to get x3 multiplied by w8 raised to 0. But what is w8 raised to 0? Any number raised to 0 is 1, so w8 raised to 0 is 1, and I'm going to get your x3 back, right? But what is w8 raised to 2? So to recall, okay, W 8 raised to 0 will be minus j, minus 1. W 8 raised to 2 will be minus 1. Okay, just to recall, we will put the circle over here. This is W 8 raised to 0. We have 8 total sides. Now we have w8 raised to 0, w8 raised to 1, w8 raised to 2, and w8 raised to 3 and so on and so forth. So w8 raised to 2 is minus 1. This is plus 1. This is 0.707 minus j.707. This is minus 1. And again it will go so on. So w8 raised to 2 is minus 1. Okay. So it is minus 1. Now I'm going to multiply x4 by minus 1. So I'm going to get over here as x4 with a minus sign. Right. Okay. Next, I get x5 over here. Then I get x6 over here. Then I get w8 raised to 0 multiplied by x7 will give me x7 as it is. And this will give me minus x8 because w8 raised to 2 is minus 1. So this is x raised to minus 8. Right. So please remember x1, x2, x3, x4 are combination of samples. Like x1 stands for x0 plus x4. X2 stands for x0 minus x4. X3 stands for x2 plus x, x6. Okay. So these are what I've just given a random analogy to each of them. Instead of writing the huge numbers, we have written them into smaller parts. Now, x1, wherever the two lines meet, we are going to add them. So x1 added with x3, you'll get x1 added with x3. Then you will get x2 added with x4. So you'll get x2 added with x4. Then you will get x1 subtracted with x3. So x1 minus x3. X2 subtracted minus of minus, which will be plus. So x1 plus x4. Here I will have all above when it carries x5, then it is coming from x7, so x5 plus x7, then x6 plus x8, sorry, x6 minus x8, here also x2 minus x4, then x6, x5 minus x7 and x6 plus x6 plus x8 because it is minus into minus, right? So this is what the new symbols that we got now. So let us recombine and give a new value to it, a new name. I give A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H. So now we got x1 plus x2 represented as A, x2 plus x4 represented as B, and so on and so forth. Okay, now let us go to the last stage. This is the second stage. Let us go to the last stage. For the last stage, we will go from this point directly to the fifth point. First line to fifth line. Second line to sixth line. Third line to seventh line. And fourth line to eighth line. Right. Similarly, I will do the reverse mapping. First to fifth, second to sixth, three to eight, three to seven, and four to eight. Agreed. And last four lines will have minus one. So I will have, let me write with another color, otherwise to confuse you. This is minus one, minus one, minus one, and minus one. Okay. Then bring all the constant to each point. A will come as it is your A, B will come as it is over your B. This is C and this is D. There's no change with A, B, C, D. E, when I now E, F, G, H will be multiplied by a multiplier over here. Okay. And the multiplier over here is W8 raised to 0, W8 raised to 1, W8 raised to 2, and W8 raised to 3. So all red multipliers will be multiplied to E, F, G, and H. Okay. So now when I write the final answer, I will get that multiplying factor to it. Now I'll multiply A plus this comes from E into W8 raised to 0. W8 raised to 0 is 1. So E will not get affected. So A plus E. Now If I go here, I see B is added with F, but multiplied by W it raised to 1. So I'll get B plus W 8 raised to 1, okay, F, right? Then we will go to C. C added with G with W 8 raised to 2 as a multiplier, but we know W 8 raised to 2 is minus 1. So I'm going to get C minus G, okay, because W 8 raised to 2 is minus 1. Then I'm going to get D added with H with W 8 raised to 3. So this is D plus W 8 raised to 3 into H. Similarly, we will have subtraction. So this will be A minus E. This will be then B minus W 8 raised to 1 into F. Then W 8, this is C minus W 8 raised to 2 into G, which is minus 1. So C plus G. D minus D minus W 8 raised to 3 into H. Okay. Now how to write the last? This is a final stage. So after the final stage, we will be getting the X of K values. So this is X of 0. This is X of 1. This is X of 2. X of 3. X of 4. X of 5. X of 6. And X of 7. So we are going to get 7 DFT samples from the time domain samples. So this is time, which is X of N, and this is X of K. So we have time on one side and frequency on the second side. How many stages are there total? There are total 3 stages: a small crisscross, a larger crisscross, and the most larger crisscross. The first crisscross is between 2 lines. Next crisscross is between 4 lines. And final crisscross is between 8 lines. Okay. So whenever you put in the first stage, the second line will have minus 1. In the second stage, the last 2 lines will have the minus 1. And in the last stage, last 4 lines will have the minus 1. So last 4 lines minus 1. Last 2 lines minus 1 and last 1 line minus 1. So third stage, 4 ones, last lines. Second stage, 2 ones, last 2 lines. And first stage, 1 time minus 1, second line always. Okay, multiplier, before second stage, 2 multipliers, W8 raised to 0, W8 raised to 2. And third stage, 4 multipliers, W8 raised to 0, 1, 2 and 3. So this is what a flow graph of 8-point DIT FFT looks like. Thank you.